Hey there, I'm Nat.
And I'm Lo, and this is Nat and Lo's 20% Project, where we go around Google learning about all the stuff we're curious about.
And this episode is all about Android Auto, which, if you don't know, is a version of Android that works in cars. So you can do things like get directions and send text messages and listen to music without needing to use your phone while you're driving. Back when we made our episode about Android Marshmallow and met Hiroshi, he told us about the Android Auto Research Lab, where they do a bunch of testing to help inform the design of Android Auto.
So welcome to our simulator. Basically what we do is we have participants come in, we have them drive.
Can we be your test subjects, guinea pigs?
Yes, definitely.
So today we're going into the lab and behind the wheel with Greg and Andy.
And just a warning in advance, Lo is going to talk about donuts a lot during this episode. So anytime you hear her say, donut, tweet us and we'll have a surprise for you. So now on with the episode.
So we have a bunch of different equipment that we're going to put on. So who wants to volunteer?
I'm volunteering Natalie.
I do need glasses when I drive, so.
Greg told us that there's three main types of driver distraction that they're testing for: visual distraction, cognitive distraction, and manual distraction. And there's special equipment to help test each kind.
This is an eye tracker, so there's cameras here that face towards your eye, and then there's a camera that looks out where your eyes look. And so we use this to essentially see where people are looking while they drive. Okay, now you can look at something random and they can tell you where you're looking, right?
You're looking down the road, down at the screen. Looking at your wheel,
my feet.
You just have to drive at 50 miles an hour, and you want to keep a constant distance between you and the car ahead of you. Good, so now why don't we do a task while you do this? So tap into your media.
Okay.
The main thing that we want to look at is how long is a single glance when you're looking at the interface.
Anything that takes your eyes off the road for more than a couple of seconds can be a safety concern.
So they're building Android Auto to encourage short glances so you don't have to stare at it to use it.
Do we want to try out some other stuff? Do you guys want to see some other research equipment?
Yep.
Cool.
Another way to test visual distraction is with these occlusion goggles that turn on and off at random intervals to mimic what it's like driving, where most of the time your eyes need to be on the road, and you only have these quick glances that you can actually spend trying to complete a task. So if you want to try this out, it feels kind of like this. Try to find Sloth Slotherson from your missed calls. Did you find him?
So why don't we do DRT on this one?
What does that stand for?
Detection response task. You want your mind to be on the road, not just your eyes on the road. And so we use DRT as a method to evaluate cognitive load.
So on a 3 to 5 second interval, this will buzz and then press the button as soon as possible.
So we look at how long would it take you to respond when you don't have a lot of workload versus once we start giving you tasks, how long does it take to respond?
Altogether, all these tests are basically giving the team a bigger picture of what it's like to use Android Auto.
Which has helped them make design decisions.
Like the font they use, type size, color, contrast, how things are organized on the screen.
But you can only fake drive in a fake car for so long, and so we were ready for the next phase of testing. We just needed, you know, some place to drive. And luckily, I was hungry.
Drive to Stan's Donut Shop.
Here are your directions.
The car has a USB port, you just plug it into our phone, it locks you out on the phone, and everything you would want to do while driving is now on the screen of the car.
All the things that you think you shouldn't be able to do when you're driving, you basically can't do with Android Auto. You can't write and send long emails, you can't watch videos, you can't play games.
And you can't read anything longer than 120 characters.
Which is shorter than a tweet.
Text Joey Mangini.
What's the message?
Would you like a donut?
Right now, Android Auto is available in over 100 models from tons of different car brands, and they continue to do research and testing to make it accessible to more people.
We as designers and researchers, we have ideas of what is the right solution for inside the car, but it's amazing how often we're surprised.
That's the true value of testing, to one, verify that you really did have the correct solution and you have the data to back it up, and two, discover things that otherwise you never would have.
Very good job. You can pull over now, or you can just stop the semi either way.
I can never go 100 miles an hour on the road, so I might as well.
And drive straight through cars. Whoa, Whoa. I didn't feel that. Don't throw up on me, okay?
No.